Alright guys, so in this tutorial we're going to be going over this house here. I'll give you a tour of the interior at the end of the video, but there is a specific video where I talk about every little part of this house, and a link will be in the description or probably in the related videos. So let's go build! And this building starts just as most of my buildings do, with the typical kind of shape. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4 up as opposed to 3, normally I do 3. 3 block gap, 1, 2, 3, 4, oops, being careful with the sideways logs so they actually go the right way. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4, so that we've got a 3-chunk wide house. I'm going to be calling these chunks, I don't mean the Minecraft chunks, I just mean like sections, I guess I could call them sections, probably, yeah, shut up. And then we're going to come up another 2 backwards, and then 3 along the back. Oops, there we go. And there is our basic outline. Next, because I know that starting from a position like this can be quite daunting, we're going to start to fill out our walls just to give us a little bit more shape and give us a better idea of how the house is going to look when it's done. So we'll just add a line of these along here, and then 2 blocks of stone up on each side, oops, like this, on each side of where the windows are going to be. Obviously you can block off some of these if you don't want them to be windows, but most of them will be, so that's fine. When you've done that, we're going to take our logs and we're going to place some sideways logs going along the top of all of these blocks. Next, we're going to add on some cobblestone and we're going to go all the way up these outside logs like this. Now we're going to add on some steps all along the bottom. And we're going to add some around the top, so we're going to go on each side of all of these top pieces and on the front, so we're creating kind of pillars. Oops, this bit can take quite a long time, especially if you keep cocking up like I just did. It's worth noting that on these end walls it's probably best to have these angled this way so that it looks good from the shortest wall, because on the shortest wall you're more likely to see both sides at once. Next we're going to add a ring of cobblestone all the way around on top of these pillars. Oops. Now we're going to start off by worrying about just one wall of the upstairs, and then we'll apply this to the other walls. So first of all we're going to take our planks like this and place them upright on top of each of these upside down stairs. Then we're going to place them facing outwards along each of them, and then we're going to bridge the gaps in between with some sideways logs, so create this. Then we're going to take our steps that we're going to be using for the roof and we're going to place them on the underside here. Obviously this is optional, but I think it makes quite a nice effect. Now we're going to start placing some vertical pieces, and this is where, if you're not using my custom texture pack edit of John Smith's, everything's going to start looking a bit weird. You can find the download for this texture pack in the description, but if you can't use my texture pack then I recommend using wood for this piece. So we're going to fill in these gaps here, oops, like that. And then we're going to take the material that we're making the roof out of, which is going to be dark wood, and we're going to place it along like that. I'm going to place another cross block in each of the gaps and pop a block on top, and you'll see why we haven't used this log here shortly. So now that that's one wall complete, we're going to go and do the same on the other side. I'll speed this bit up for you so it's not boring. There we go. Now we're going to start on our end wall. And we'll be doing a little bit of a different kind of design along here. So we're going to take our steps that we're going to be making the roof out of. We're going to place them on top of each one of these outward facing steps. And then we're going to place them upside down stairs, clicking on this small bit here, assuming you're on 1.3 of course, to create this kind of shape like that. So that's there, there. And you're also going to want to do this on the ends, like this, and like this. Then on the next layer up, we're going to take our steps again and place them on top of the steps that we placed before, and then fill in the rest of it with half slabs like this, leaving some there and there to complete our secondary bits of arches. Now on our end wall, we're going to take our logs up and we're going to go up so that we have a 2-block gap above the half slabs like that. So we'll go up that many, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4. We're then going to take our logs and complete this wall here so it's flush with this cobblestone. Then we'll take our 43, which is a full block of half slabs, and bring this along all the gaps like that. Then add on two blocks of the white cross wool, and then start on the actual triangle on top. And the way we're going to do that is by placing three blocks facing towards us, crossing off the top of these, and then starting to work our way up. So we will go 1, 2, 3, 4 up. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1. So we get this shape, and then we're going to clear out the inside of this shape and place some blocks in this pattern to make way for a nice little window, and we can fill in the gaps again with our cross wool like that. I'll do this again on the other side, but I'll speed it up for your pleasure. And there we go. So this is about as far as the basic framework goes. From everything from now on, it's going to start getting a little bit more complicated. Obviously, we're going to be doing the roofing and things like that. But before we do that, we need to add in this tower, because the tower is one of the most distinctive features of this build. So the bottom part of the tower is going to be this block here. And normally, this would be different, obviously making this in some kind of porch or something like that. But I'm going to leave that for now. We're just going to worry about what's above. So we're going to delete all of these blocks like this, cough, and then we're going to go up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that. Now we can do some decoration here. We can place some blocks like this to make it look separated from the wood. That's quite important. And then we're going to come up to the top, the left and the right blocks we're going to do this with, and the middle block we're going to get rid of, because that's going to be the base of our tower. So I'll just do one wall like this, and then we're going to start adding in the other walls of the tower. So the tower itself makes this shape like this. So what we're looking at is this wall here. So we're going to come along to the side and go 1, 2, 3, and then fill in the gaps. Obviously this block here would be the same as this block, but we're not going to worry about this one because it will look messy later, and remove the middle one. And the same goes for here, where we're going to have 1, 2, 3, and then that block like that. So we're just making those two sides look the same. And then we're going to have another wall here, oops, not here, sorry, there. And this one, we're just going to remove this block, place in all of our wood, oops. And that's all the tower that's going to kind of interact with the roof. So everything on top of the tower is now free from the rest of the build, which is quite handy if you want to do something different with the top of the tower, for example. So for the top of the tower, we're going to add a little block on each of these corners to help us out, like that. And then we're going to go up two blocks from each of these corners, like that. And then we can remove the blocks. Now most of these two blocks we placed here are probably going to get changed into another type of wood later on, but for now they'll be fine. We're going to add in our nice crossed wool here, along around like this. Now the wall that's facing the rest of the building we're going to fill up, because that's not going to there's not going to be room for a window there when we're finished. But then we can add another block on top like this, and go over the whole top with wood. So the front should look like this, and it's also worth noting that we're probably going to change this into wood, this into wood, this into wood, these two, and it will also be changing this block, this block, this block, and oops, this block. So you might want to do that now, but you can leave that till later, that's fine. So now we're going to start on the roof, and the easiest way to do the roof is to cover it in a series of kind of rules that will help us out. Learning the roof block by block is going to be tricky and painstaking, and there's not really much point in doing it. So what we're going to do is take this bit here, this is going to be our the bit of roof that we're practicing on, and we're just going to try out our design. So we're going to place that exactly as we normally would for a roof. And down here we're going to place an upside down stair on each side, and then a right way up stair on top. And we're going to have these two gaps, which we're going to fill with two upside down stairs like this. So you might want to pause and just get the hang of doing that before you try and do the rest of the roof, because that will just make life so much easier and you won't need to watch me doing it block for block. So we're going to do the same on this bit here. So that's two coming out on each side, an upside down block, a right way up block, and then two upside down blocks like that. Then we're going to take a full block of our roofing material and we're going to fill up all these gaps. So that's they're going to come out two there, so it meets this piece of roof. And then we're going to place a half slab at the top of these two blocks and on top of the two top bits, and I'm going to place two stairs pointing out, and that's going to be the same design all the way around, so I'll speed up me doing the rest of it. There we go. Okay, so now we're going to start work on the end wall, and this is going to be a much more traditional approach. What we're going to do is, take our blocks all the way down the sides, like that, and then give it a one block overhang. And for now, we'll just go down till it meets the other roof. There we go. And this one block overhang is going to come all the way down to this corner piece, so you will see a little bit of wood sticking through there. And if that annoys your OCD, then you can go ahead and change this block of wood, but I'd rather keep it because, well, actually there's no reason to keep it. You can go ahead and change that. Now, to make our roof look a little bit more chunky, we're going to come underneath and place our stairs upside down like this. And just to finish the look, we're going to place a half slab at each end. But this is, of course, optional because that will mess up the kind of line you've got going on there. So again, I'll do this on the other end just to show you. Where it comes to this tower, what I'd like to do is fill up this gap here so we don't have any loose gaps. Bring the roof down the edge and then delete this block and place another stair block like that. So let me go and pop all this on. It should look nice. There we go. Now we're going to roof the tower while we still can. This is going to get quite tricky to roof when we've added in this bit of roof, so we'll do the tower now. Exactly the same concept as the front of the building, so we're going to bring out two blocks like that, bring out another block like this. So first of all, I'll just do that. I think that made life easier. Do all the blocks facing the same way up first. Just makes life so much simpler. Oops. And then go underneath with all the other ones. Now it's worth noting that there are two empty slots here which you can go ahead and place some more blocks on. And all the blocks that we're going to be placing that aren't kind of symmetrical are going to be facing forward so that the front of the tower looks the best and the side looks the not so best, I guess. There we go, and that is where the similarities are going to end. From now on, we're going to be building this nice steep kind of curve up to the tower. So we'll fill in these corners first so that they don't look weird, and then we'll place a full block right behind the kind of flicky uppy bit, and then another full block on each of these, so we've got this shape going on. Then we're going to place in our corners going up, and again we're going to be placing the end, these unsymmetrical pieces, so they look best viewed from this angle, and then filling in the gaps going up another block and doing the same thing, and then going up another two like that. And that is the top of our tower. There are some details that we will add, like this one over here, but I won't add that till the end. The next tricky bit is connecting up the roofs. So what we're going to do is bring back each one of these little sticky outy bits by one block. And then we're going to place some full blocks along. Where these two are going to meet, there'll be one there, and there, 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 and there. So that's there, 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 and where these two are going to meet. Now we'll add some steps in these little gaps, so there'll be one there, and there, and then carry on the half slabs on top, one block more. Now that's pretty much all the meeting that we're going to be doing. All the rest of it is going to be quite straightforward, so we'll go ahead and add in the rest of our roof. Now where we've got problems like this, where the tower isn't quite meeting up, we're just going to plonk in some full blocks like there, just to neaten up all these edges. Now, before we add our top piece, we're going to add in our kind of fancy that bit. I have no idea what you'd go about calling it, but we're going to take some half slabs and place them on where the beam is, where this bit's sticking up, and then every other block from then on. So that'll be there, 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 and it should line up perfectly that the last one is on the beam as well. Then we're going to take our steps and run all the way along, adding in another little bit of roof. Next, we're going to not forget to fill in this little piece here with full blocks, and we're going to add in a line of wood like this. On top of that, we're going to be putting some fences, but I won't do that for just a second because we need to still sort out this end piece, where we're going to take our step and place one step facing up and one step facing down to create a nice little hole here. Then we're going to place a full block on top to create this nice Gothic end piece. Now for the fences going along the top, we're going to be taking some fence gates and also some fences. And we're going to place fence, gate, fence all the way along. And the last one should be a gate. Now at the end of all of these you can place some kind of details. And on top of here I recommend going up three blocks, placing a block on each side. Oops, all four sides, sorry. And then placing four fence gates, and this kind of creates a kind of compassy, weather veiny type thing, which looks quite gothic-y. It might be a bit too big for some people's taste, but you can always just add like a little spire or something. So now, just before I let you guys fiddle around with all like the little details and stuff like that, we're going to be doing the interior. And the interior, when you first go into it, ooh, I actually forgot a window there. The interior, when you first go into it, is going to be quite messy, and you're not going to really know what to put where. So let's try and make some sense out of all of this. First of all, we'll add in a bit more definition to these lines by adding in some blocks, hiccup, like this. And then some beams that will go all the way from the bottom right up to the top. Like there, and here. Like that. We're also going to have some beams carrying on from here. They will go out to meet these center beams. And some on top of the beams that we have here. Like that. We're also, where beams start to meet, it's a good idea to put one facing upwards. It looks a lot better, and it also reminds you that you're probably missing something there. And then we're going to add one all the way along the middle as well. So that's, oops, there, there, and there. So that's our downstairs, all beamed up, Scotty. Yeah. And then we're going to start doing the upstairs. So the first thing we're going to do is make our roof look a little bit better. So we're going to come down here. I'm going to say, oh, you stupid block. And place blocks going up, right up into the roof. I'm also going to place some blocks going up from here. This is very optional, having these blocks here, a lot of people wouldn't have them there, but I think it really helps with the interior, it helps a lot, so I'll leave them in. We're also going to add in a cross beam, which is going to come out from there, and this is 1, 2, 3 blocks above the floor. So there and there. And one more cross beam going all the way from one side to the other. Okay, so I decided to cut that video there, just so I can give you a tour of the inside of the house, just saying what I did, so you guys can make your own mind up. Here we've got a kind of foyer area, this is one block raised up. You come down into a kind of kitchen area, you can see what I've done with the beams and the roof, like some designs there. This is where you come in, that goes down to a basement, which I didn't cover in the video, but never mind. We've got some tables and some stuff like that. There's a fireplace here, I'll show you that from the outside at the end of the video. And then if we go upstairs, there are a few rooms kind of off to the side, but we'll ignore them. And then upstairs, we have the main room, which looks like this. We've got the fireplace, we've got like a little area there, another little area here, and a bedroom. The staircase is obviously just on the other side of this wall. We also have a little bedroom squeezed in here. And if we go up this ladder here, which I wouldn't recommend putting a ladder there, by the way, that was a bad design, I had to change the roof around a little bit. We have a bit of attic which looks over the top of the rest of the house, and we have the enchanting table and the tower. So yeah, let's just go have a go have a quick look at this chimney. This is something I probably should have covered in the tutorial, but it's too late now. But the chimney is very simple. It's you can just pause the video and see where it goes, but it just goes straight up the middle and then pops out on top here with some stone bricks coming down the roof. So there you go. There's also some ideas for finishing touches you can apply to the build, such as the shutters and things. But I really recommend watching the video which I did specifically for this build. So thanks for watching. Don't forget to leave a rating if you haven't. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't been here before, and check out my other videos. Don't forget to like my Facebook page, where there's all kind of goodies stuff, and you get releases earlier than the actual video, because obviously uploading takes time. And I will see you guys next time.